athletic trainer, as well as I teach a physical therapy athletic training program. And this year we have a beginning class, which is a first year class, as well as an advanced class, which is a second year class. Hopefully next year we'll have a third year. And it's really cool because in Washington State, we're one of the only states actually has a state sports medicine program kind of designed so that we actually have a state sports medicine competition once a year. And then within our League of Wesco, we do a Wesco sports medicine competition. Last year we held it here at Glacier Peak High School, so we got to host it and put it together, and all of our students competed and had fun with it. And this year it's going to be at Linwood High School.
So how many sports teams do you work with here at Glacier Peak?
I work with all the sports teams. The only ones I really don't go to the events for are things like swimming, because they're off campus. Otherwise, I cover everything from soccer to football, wrestling, baseball, softball, tennis. I'm here for cross country, track, basketball. What are those sports? I cover all the sports teams, all home events, and the only events I usually travel for are varsity football. And then I also travel with some of the sports, for example, soccer, football, when we go to playoff games as well.
What is your view on Glacier Peak's rules and safety concerning concussions in football? I'm sure there's a lot of attention being drawn to concussions now, where 10, 20 years ago, we didn't really pay attention to that.
Right, so I think Glacier Peak, it's really cool because we have state-of-the-art equipment. We have the impact testing software where we have athletes come in and they take a preliminary test to get a baseline of where they're at in terms of their cognitive function, their reaction time to answering questions and memorizing shapes and words and things of that nature. And then if they do sustain a concussion or we think they may have a concussion, it's another tool to kind of add into our toolbox where we can reassess them and compare to where they're at. In terms of symptoms as well as the cognitive function after they have that concussion, it helps us with dealing with the return to play process and protocol. And it's cool because the coaches here at Glacier Peak definitely are concerned with the athlete's safety first rather than, oh, but it's a big game, we have to play. So that part makes my job easier. They send them to me, even if maybe they don't have a concussion, they're just concerned, and then I can do that evaluation process. And so we follow the state protocol and state law in terms of returning to play. So it is a 5-day process to return to play to a game after the 24-hour symptom free. So it is a process, but it is again concerning for the athlete's health and safety. We're lucky in that we have a training room the size almost of a college training room. We can do lots of rehab in here with this nice open space where we can have people doing running and jumping exercises to help strengthen them. Over here we have the hydroculator, which we use for the moist heat packs. So before practices, athletes can come in and heat, or during again the rehab process. We have all the coolers, we have our ice machine, we have a whirlpool, which we can use as hot or cold, which is a pretty sweet deal. So oftentimes the track athletes or football during 2 days will come in after practices and do the cold ice baths to kind of prevent soreness for future practices and games. And these are just random rehab tools, and it's locked up in that cabinet right now, but we do have an ultrasound and stim unit, which is helpful in helping control pain as well as just helping with the rehab process of injuries. And we have this neat little device over here. I call it the stretchy band station. So we can set the stretchy band up kind of any level we want to help assist with rehab exercises.